Let's start the session for today, and the first thing that we are going to cover is the concept on algebra that is related to series, right? Now let me write a very simple series in front of you. 3 7 10 14. What will be the next term? Sorry. Now tell me what will be the next one. My bad. Right, tell me what will be the next one. Nineteen is the next term. We know that the common difference is same, and we call the such series AP. In series को हम क्या कहते हैं? AP कहते हैं. All right, we know this. And what is the formula for the nth term of this AP? The formula is AN is equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. This is the general form. Now what we are going to learn today is about the double difference series and the triple difference series. What are those series? In this type of series, in AP, the difference at the first level between all the terms are same. If only at the first level the difference between all the time is same, which means now how do we generalize these terms? These terms are nothing but general linear equation. Each term is a type of a it can be expressed in a linear equation. Ax plus b, each term is ax plus b type, right? Where x is the xth term, right? So if I am talking about the first term, I will put x as 1. At x is equal to 1, a into 1 plus b, the value of first term is 3, right? Why we are doing this, we will understand it in a little while. At x is equal to 2, right, a into 2 plus b will give you the second term, that is 7. All right, now if I see it, a plus b is equal to 3, 2a plus b is equal to 7. So what is the solving these two? The value of a is what? The value of a is 4. The value of b is what? The value of b is minus 1. In dono ko solve karke kya aata hai? The value of a is 4. The value of b is minus 1. Now let us say you have to calculate the fourth term of the series. If you have to calculate the fourth term of the series, you have this ax plus b as the general term. So I know the value of a is 4. So 4a, the value of b is minus 1. So 4x minus 1. The value of a is 4. So 4x minus 1. So value of a is 4. So 4 into 4 minus 1. 16 minus 1. 15. This is the value of this term. This is the value of this term. All right. Now, remember, when the difference is same at the first level, we define every term as a linear term, as a normal linear term, and we can find the values of a and b in order to find the in any terms here. Up to this step, is it clear, everyone? All right. Find sum of first 50 terms of the series. Find the sum of first 50 terms of the series. The series is 3, 1, minus 2, minus 6, minus 11, minus 17, and so on. All right. Try this, everyone. Yes, Anubhav, we can say that. Now, for the people who do not know the concept, for the people who know the concept, it is very easy. For the people who do not know the concept, let us understand something behind it, right? Rest, you all can continue doing. If I see the difference here, 3 to 1, the difference is minus 2. 1 to minus 2, the difference is minus 3. Minus 2 to minus 6, the difference is minus 4. The difference is minus 5. The difference is minus 6. Now, when I see at the first difference is not same. The first difference is not same. Had the first difference been same, each term can be generalized as a linear equation. I told you, right? Now, if I look at the second difference here, right? And if I look at the second difference here, minus 2 to minus 3, minus 3 to minus 4, minus 4. Minus 4 to minus 5, minus 4. Minus 5 to minus 6, minus 4. Now in this, my second level difference is same every time. In this, my second level difference. So when the first difference is same, we define it as a general term as a degree one equation. When second difference is same, we define it as a second degree equation, which means each term will now be defined as a quadratic equation. Her term ko hum ek quadratic expression ke saath generalize kar sakte hain. What do I mean by this? That each term of x is equal to, can be written as ax square plus bx plus c, right? Tx is equal to ax square plus bx plus c. Please remember, we have to find the sum of first 50 terms. We do not have to find the 50th term. All right. Now what is the next step? I need to find the value of a, b and c in order to generalize the result. Since I need to find the value of a, b and c, which means there are three unknown variables, which means I need now three equations for them, right? It is a second degree equation. Second degree equation means it is a second difference equation, which means I will take the second degree equation. Second degree is quadratic. So I have taken this. All right. Now what I will take A as, sorry. Now what I will do, if I put A as one, X as one, the first term, it would be, यार अनिकेत किसी ने कहा है आंसर लिखने को एवरीवन इज ट्राइंग व्हाई आर यू राइटिंग द आंसर्स टर्म वन वुड बी ए इनटू वन स्क्वायर प्लस बी इनटू वन प्लस सी राइट दैट वुड बी इक्वल टू व्हाट दैट वुड बी इक्वल टू थ्री आई डिडंट नो राइट दैट वुड बी इक्वल टू थ्री नाउ व्हेन टर्म टू व्हेन आई टॉक अबाउट द टर्म टू वुड बी X as 2, A into 2 square plus B into 2 plus C, that is equal to 1. That is the second term, right? The first equation is giving me that A plus B plus C is equal to 3. Second equation is giving me 4A plus 2B plus C is equal to 1. Similarly, term 3, A into 3 square plus B into 3 plus C is equal to, that is equal to minus 2. That is equal to minus 2. All right. Which means this will be generalized as 9a plus 3b plus c is equal to the third term of the series, that is minus 2. Right. Now, everyone, use these three equations and find me the value of a, b, c. Everyone, try to find it out. Give your answers after a minute. Right. I will solve at my end. You please solve at your end. Give the answers after a minute. I will ask you to. हाँ अंकित बताऊंगा मैं अभी आके बताऊंगा यस तन्मय व्हेन द डिग्री इज द व्हेन देयर इज द फर्स्ट डिफरेंस सेम यू कैन ऑलवेज फाइंड इट थ्रू द लीनियर फंक्शन अप्रोच दो वी अवॉइड दैट व्हाई बिकॉज एपी इज मच सिंपल इज क्वाइट सिंपल टू यूज राइट अरिथमेटिक प्रोग्रेशन बहुत ईजी होता है यूज करना और राइट लेकिन फिर भी अगर आप करना चाहो तो उसको ऐसे कर सकते हो So when I will solve this, when I will solve this, I will get the value of A as minus 1 by 2, B as minus 1 by 2, right, and C as 4. Right, C as 4. So these are the values. Can someone verify, are you getting the same results? All right. Up to this step, anyone, any doubt up to this step? Anyone, any doubt up to this step? You cannot take x as negative. X is the term number. Term number 1, term number 2, term number 3, and so on. If you take x as negative, term number minus 5, that term does not exist. All right? Okay. Now, can I say, now this is my general term, right? This is my general term. So can I say for this expression, the general term will be defined as minus 1 by 2 x square minus 1 by 2 x plus 4 is equal to plus 4. Right. This is the general term now for this expression. All right. Is this clear? Yes or no? All right. This is clear. No, Sanskriti, we actually appreciate it when the people respond to all panelists and attendees. It tells you that what everyone is going through, nothing else. And I request everyone to change their comment settings to all panelists and attendees, nothing else. All right. Now, up to this level, it is quite clear, right? Up to this level, it is quite clear. Now, this is my general expression. So I'm just erasing everything out. All right. So my general expression is, should I erase it out? Koi chakkar to nahi? Has everyone noted it down? I'll keep it here. So this is my general equation. Term of x is equal to minus 1 by 2 x square minus 1 by 2 x plus 4. Now, if I was asked to find the 50th term, agar mujhse 50th term nikalne ko kaha gaya hota, I would have substituted x as 50 and I would have found the result. But no, I am not asked to find the 50th term. I am asked to find the summation of x is equal to 1 to x is equal to 50. I am asked to find the summation, which means summation of this equation. Right. So each term, see now, if you see it in a nutshell, I have to find the value of this minus 1 by 2 into 1 square minus 1 by 2 into 1 plus 4. This is the first term. The second term would be minus 1 by 2 into 2 square minus 1 by 2 into 2 plus 4 and so on and so forth. This is what my general equation will be. All right. I hope it is clear up to this point that this is what my general equation is. Since I have to use square again, see if I take it common 1 square, 2 square up to 50 square, 1, 2 up to 50, 4, 4, 50 times, I can directly apply the summation formula here. That I have to find the sum of 50 squares. I have to find the sum of 50 natural numbers. And I have to find the sum of 4 times 50. So this, right? Up to this step, is it clear, everyone? When I'm writing this, is this clear? Right? All right. So minus 1 by 2 into, now x, what is the sum of first n perfect squares? First n perfect squares ka sum kya hota hai apne paas? X into x plus 1 into 2x plus 1 divided by 6, where x is 50. Here x is equal to 50, right? Minus 1 by 2 into sum of first natural numbers kya hota hai? X into x plus 1 by 2. Again, here x is equal to 50. See, I'm writing all these expressions intentionally so that it brings some more clarity. All right, plus 200. Now just put x as 50 here. Minus 1 by 2 into 50 into 51 into 101 by 6. Minus 1 by 2 into 50 into 51 by 2 plus 200. Solve this and find the value. You will get it as minus 2190. Right. Good, Aniket, your answer was correct. This is the final answer. Finally, is this clear, everyone? All right. So what have we learned? That if the difference is at first level, the term is linear, the general term is linear. If there is a second difference is same, the term is quadratic. Had there been a case where third difference is same, then I will take the general expression as a cubic expression. Ax cube plus bx square plus cx plus d. Then I will have to form four equations in order to find four variables and proceed. All right. Though CAT does not ask such type of questions, but just to gain the clarity and the concept, we have covered this. All right. Shall we move ahead? चले आगे. See when the difference is like this, let's say this is the series I do 3, 7, 11, 15 and so on. The difference is same at the first level, right? Each term, since the difference is same at the first level, each term will be defined as AX plus B, right? General linear equation, first term, rearranging. If there was second level, this is the expression. If there is third level difference same, then this is the expression. All right. In all the cases in this, you will find two values in order to find the answer. In this, you will find three values. In this, you will find four values in order to form the expression. All right. Right. Sure. Let's move to the data set now. Has everyone got their stopwatches ready? All right. And before we move ahead, just one information that our final batch is starting soon. All right. The last batch by Quantifiers will be starting in a few days. So if any of you is interested to enroll, you can visit our website and enroll. And if you have any doubts around anything, you can always connect with me at the number provided in the description box. Right. And we will be at your service. All right. I will take the course doubts at the end. Abhi ruk jao. Let's do this. Now this is the set. How many of you are seeing this set for the first time or haven't tried this before? Okay. Try this set. You have 9 minutes for the same. Like time up to 4-5. ठीक है गौरव, नोटेड, वी विल डील विद देम. Are you done, guys? How many of us are not able to find a starting point? कि समझ ही नहीं आ रहा करना क्या है इसमें. Except for me, anyone else? All right. So I am not alone. No, I am not alone. All right. All right. All right. All right. चलो. Let us try to find out. See. Normally, what happens in game and tournament questions, there are some goals, goals against, goals with, draws, and everything around that. There is some information on these things. But when I read the conditions over here, no. When I read the conditions over here, everything is given in the terms of who won by how much, who lost by how much. All the conditions are based on the goal difference. Right? Is that thing understandable? Yes or no? कि अगर हम 6-5 कंडीशंस हैं, पांचों कंडीशंस पढ़े, सो ऑल द कंडीशंस आर जस्ट बेस्ड अपॉन गोल डिफरेंस. ऑलराइट, सिंस ऑल द कंडीशंस आर बेस्ड ऑन गोल डिफरेंस, दिस इज द बिगेस्ट क्लू ऑफ दिस क्वेश्चन दैट वी शुड वर्क ओनली ऑन गोल डिफरेंस एंड नथिंग एल्स. ऑलराइट, बट हाउ, लेट अस सी. आई नो दैट देयर आर टू टीम्स, ए एंड बी. ऑलराइट, दे आर टुगेदर प्लेइंग 100 मैचेस. Both the teams are doing a minimum of 1-1 goal each. Both the teams are going a minimum of one goal each. So there is no match in which either A has scored a zero goal or B has scored a zero goal. There is no such match, right? And in any particular match, the total number of maximum goals done by the two teams is 4. हाँ जी, जहाँ जी, बताइए क्या doubt है आपका? चलो आप लिख लो, फिर मैं तब तक वापस आता हूं आपके डाउट पे. सिंस द मैक्सिमम नंबर ऑफ गोल्स डन कलेक्टिवली बाय द टू टीम्स इज 4 इन एनी ऑफ द मैच. अरे, इन अ मैच द टोटल नंबर ऑफ गोल्स स्कोर्ड इन एनी मैच वाज एट मोस्ट 4. इन एनी मैच टोटल नंबर ऑफ गोल्स स्कोर्ड, द नंबर ऑफ गोल्स स्कोर्ड इन एनी ऑफ द मैच मींस टोटल जो उन्होंने मिलके गोल किए, नॉट बाय अ सिंगल टीम, मिलके जो उन्होंने गोल किए वो 4 है. These are not individual things. These are the total number of goals in any match. See, up to this point, they are not talking about any single team. Up to this point, what they are saying, the two teams played 100 matches. Then it is also known that the number of goals scored in any match was at most 4. किसी भी मैच में ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा 4 गोल हुए हैं, ठीक है? किसी भी मैच में अगर ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा 4 गोल हुए हैं और हर टीम ने मिनिमम 1 गोल किया है, and every team has done a minimum of 1 goal. Which means the maximum number of goal teams, the maximum number of goal a team can do is 1, 2 and 3 itself. Nothing else. 1, 2 and 3. This is the maximum number of goals available. All right. Is this clear? Yes or no? All right. Now, let us think of the cases. These are the perfect cases. 1-1 is also the draw possibility, Srinivas. 1-1 is also the draw possibility. क्या बात करते हो ब्रो, ऐसे कैसे चलेगा? Alright, so 1-1 is one possibility, right? 1-2 is another possibility. 1-3 is another possibility, right? 1-1, 1-2, 1-3. Then what is the possibility? A can do one goal. So for one goal of A, these are the cases. For two goals of A, 2-1. And 2-2 are the cases. For 3 goals of the A, there is only one possibility, 3-1. So this is the only, these are the different possibilities available. Up to this point, anyone, any doubt? No doubt, right? Okay. Just give me 1 second. Alright, now in order to proceed, I need the number for, I need a variable for everything. Sorry, what do I mean by that? I am given that like if I read the first condition, what is given to me in the first condition? In the first condition, it is given to me that the number of matches that A won, right? So A won this match and this match. The number of matches that A won was 27 more than the number of matches in which B scored at least 2 goals, right? So all these matches have to be named something in order to make the conditions and use them out. So what we will do, let us just name them. Let us just name them. All right. How do we name them? Is the are the conditions visible, everyone? Are the conditions still visible? All right. Give me 1 second. A and B, right? 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 3, 2, 1, 2, 2, and 3, 1. All right. Now these are the number of conditions, right? Let us say that these are A number of matches, these are B number of matches, these are C number of matches, these are D number of matches, these are E number of matches, and these are F number of matches. So these are the different number of matches that we have. All right. So first equation, what are the total number of matches? The total number of matches are 100. All right. The total number of matches are 100. So A plus B plus C plus D plus E plus F. All this is equivalent to 100. Right, this is the first and the basic equation. Now let us write the conditions, read the questions, and let us read the condition and write the equations. First, the number of matches that A won, right? So what are the number of matches that A won? These are this match and this match. So D and F. The number of matches that A won, that is D plus F. Is 27 more than the number of matches in which B scored at least 2 goals. At least 2 goals means this one, and this one. Now this is 27 more than this, right? So B plus C plus E plus 27. All right. After this step, is it clear, everyone? After this step, ठीक है कोई कुछ मुश्किल लिखा ही नहीं हमने. This condition done. Now read the second condition. फटाफट से second condition पढ़ के मेरे को लिख के बताओ. Let us see if you have understood or not. सेकेंड कंडीशन पढ़ो और लिख के बताओ क्या कंडीशन होगी वो. Very good Tapsi, very good everyone. Right, what is the condition? The number of matches that ended as a draw, which means 1-1 and 2-2, that is A plus E. These are equivalent to, right? These are equal to the number of matches in which A scored exactly one goal, that is A plus B plus C. Right, so A cancel. I get E is equal to B plus C as the equation. All right, this is done. Now let us read the third one. The third equation says the number of third equation banao. You have 2 minutes to make all the equations. Make the remaining three equations and then we will tally it. Fatafat se teen equations banao, uske baad hum verify karte hain ki theek hai ki nahi. Please, abhi likho mat. Do not write any equation. Right, just please. Make them and keep them with you. Then I will write it and then we will verify. Yes, Aditya, it will. Because it does not win, no. Okay. Is everyone getting the same five equations? Kindly verify for me. Is everyone getting the same equations? Now see, this was the only technical part of this question. Trust me, this was the only technical part of this question. After this, it is all, you know, gadon ki tarah calculations karna and manipulate karna equations. So no other learning from here, from this point. It is all, we have to manipulate the equations and we have to solve it, to be honest. All right. Now let's try to solve them up. I know I have BDCF. I know I have this master equation ABCDEF. I know that I have these equations, everything. All right. I somehow need to use these variables, right? C plus F is 2 plus B, 2B by 2D. Very good, Abhijana. Very good. Right. You are almost correct, I think. Okay. So let us use these equations. Equation 4. See, equation 4 says the sum of the number of matches that A did not win. Jo matches A nahi jeeta. Yani wo matches jo A hara hai, ya fir A ne draw kiye hai. All those matches, that is A, B, C and E. Right. Ye matches ya A hara hai ya isne draw kiye hai. Right. This. Aage to aapka simple, ye basically yahi problem hogi mere khayal se aapki. Clear A? Because D will be at both the side, na? D will be at both the side. ये लिखा ना यहाँ से कट के आया ये. Let's use equation number 3 and equation number 5, right? अब तो हो जाएगा, अभी भी नहीं होता काफियों का लक्ष्मण. Why I am using this? Because in this C plus F is directly given to me. C plus F is directly given to me. B plus D is used, B plus D is used. Since this is the common terms that I can see, therefore let me use this. Using this gives me, if I use C plus F is 2B plus 2D. If I replace it by 2B plus 2D, I will get B plus D as 20. I will get B plus D as 20. And if you write B plus D as C plus F, agar main B plus D ko C plus F by 2 likhta hun, then what I will get? I will get C plus F is equal to 40. Right, this is what I am getting. Now I have BDCF. I have BDCF. Right, which means the only thing left is AE. The only thing left is AE. So A plus E will be 40. Right, in the master equation I have BDCF, so A plus E will be 40. Right, is this clear, yes or no? All right, now when I look at these equations and the equations that I have with me, right, I have BD in a combination, C and F in a combination, A and E in a combinations, right, I have this ABCE, here I have BCE and DF, right? Now, what can I do? I have BD exactly. I have BD exactly, DF, C and F, all right. AE and E, all right. These are the things that I have now. I have B plus D plus C plus F is equal to 60. अरे बिकॉज अभिनव रीड द कंप्लीट कंडीशन एंड दोज इट वॉन बाय एटमोस्ट वन गोल द मैचेस विच इज लॉस्ट एंड दोज विच इट वॉन बाय एटमोस्ट वन गोल. सो ये भी तो आएगा ना 2-1 का स्कोर, उसमें वो एक गोल से तो जीतता है. Now, I have B plus C plus D plus F is equal to 60 with me. These two, right? These two are 60. Now, if I see I have DF. I have BC. I have BC. So, let me try to use this. That D plus F is equal to 60 minus B minus C. So, if I use it in the first equation, what I will get? 60 minus B minus C is equal to 27 plus B plus C plus E. 27 plus B plus C plus E. Right. So, okay. And this equation is also giving me that B plus C is E. Now I directly can use B plus C as E. 60 minus E is equal to 27 plus E plus E. 3E is equal to 33. E is equal to 11. So these matches are 11 matches, right? Finally, we have found one variable. Up to this point, is it clear? Though there is nothing logical that we are doing now, it is just substituting the values, nothing else, right? Clear hai yahan tak? Okay. Now I had this that A plus E is 40. Therefore, A will be 29. A will be 29, right? Okay. So E is B plus C. Now I know that B plus C is 11 in this equation. I know that B plus C is equal to 11 now. All right. B plus C is 11. Okay. This is also B plus C and E. B plus C and E, right? So if I will use this here, what I am getting? B plus C, A plus 11 plus E is, B plus C is E, right? A plus 11 plus 11 is equal to 15 plus F, right? This. A plus 11 plus 11 is equal to D plus F, all right? Now, A is 29 already, F is 36. A is 29 already, F is 36. Yaar, Srinivas, you are asking B plus C is E. Isko maine yaar, dekho, is B plus D tha. First equation mein to A hai hi nahi, beta. I am talking about this equation. Srinivas, for finding the value of E, I am using this equation. I am not using the upper statement. All right. So A is not even there. So F is 36 from here. F kitna aaya mere paas? 36. F is equal to 36. I know C plus F was 40. So what is the value of C? The value of C will be 4. Right. Now I know that B plus C is 11. I know that B plus C is equal to 11. So if B plus C is 11, C is 4, yani B is 7. If B is 7, 7 plus D is 13. All right. See, this was the work that I had to do. For finding this, B plus C is equal to 11 was given to me. I substituted it here. I found the value of F because B plus D was given to me. F was known to me. All right. So I found the value of C. From there, I moved on. ठीक है, क्या यहाँ तक क्लियर है सबको? इज इट क्लियर अपू दिस स्टेप? वैसे कुछ था नहीं, टू बी वेरी ऑनेस्ट, द ओनली लॉजिक वाज टू असाइन दीज वेरिएबल्स एंड मेक दीज इक्वेशंस. आफ्टर दैट देयर वाज नो लर्निंग फ्रॉम देयर ऑन. यू ओनली हैड टू बी एन एस एंड डू द वर्क, राइट? एंड इफ यू सी दीज टाइप ऑफ क्वेश्चन इन द एग्जाम, दीज शुड हैव बीन लेफ्ट बिकॉज देयर आर वेरी हाई चांसेस दैट यू डू कैलकुलेशन एरर और यू एंड अप यूजिंग द रॉन्ग कॉम्बिनेशंस ऑफ इक्वेशंस. And you end up losing a lot of time. All right. So this is simple, that type of question. All right. Now you can only answer, you can answer all the questions. How many matches ended in a draw? 1-1 and 2-2. So the answer is 40. The answer is 40. Alright. Okay. Now, how many goals did A score in all the matches that it played against B during the year? How many goals that A scored? In 29 matches, it did A one goal. In 7, it did 1. In 4, it scored 1. In 13, he scored 2. 11, he scored 2. 36, he scored 3. So 130, 156, 160, 167 and 29, 196. Right. Just calculation check kar lena ek bar sare. In how many matches did A score 2 goals more than B? So A scored 2 more than B. This is the only right. This is the only combination. So 36. What is the goal difference of B for all the matches that it played against A? The goal difference. Goal difference simply means goals done by the team, goals for, minus goals against. What is the goal difference? Just in case if someone does not know, let us say A is playing against B and A is playing against C. Manlo, there are three teams. A is winning 3-1 over here and A is winning 3-2 over here. Then the goal difference means goals done minus goals against, or it is basically goals for minus goals against. So 3 minus 1, 2, 3 minus 2, 1. The total goal difference is 3. Right? If there was a negative term, I will take it as a negative term, because it will impact the goal difference negatively. Is the concept of goal difference clear? That what is the goal difference? Right. So the goal difference here is, in the second match, 2 minus 1, 1. The goal difference is 1 for 7 matches. So 1 into 7, 7. 3 minus 1, 2. 2 into 4, 8. 1 minus 2, minus 1. Minus 1 into 13, minus 13. 2 minus 2, 0. 1 minus 3 minus 2, minus 2 into 36, minus 72. Right. Now the goal difference will be, the net goal difference is 7 and 15 minus 3, 13. 15 minus 13, 12, minus 2, minus 74. All right. Is it clear, guys? This is not even a round 99 question, buddy, to be honest. Right. So this completes our set as well as the total this. Minus 85, minus 13. Minus 85, minus 15, plus 15, minus 70. Perfect. Minus 70. Minus 85 plus 15 minus 70. All right. Okay. Done. Thank you so much, guys, for the participation.